We find here the network of a working group which has the network ID 192.122.10.0. The server S1 is part of the network. Server S2 is its backup server. S2 is currently not active. Both servers have the same IP address, that is 192.122.10.1, but they have different MAC addresses. The hosts A and B are connected to the network as well. Only host A is switched on at the moment. The figure shows the IP addresses and MAC addresses of both hosts. Host A now wants to communicate with server S1. In reality, this could, for instance, be the case if an FTP program has been started on host A. It may want to retrieve files from FTP server S1. For doing so, host A sends an ARP request to all computers in the network. S1's IP address is indicated as target. Host A's IP address and MAC address are provided as source. Server S1 inserted the addresses of host A into its ARP table. Then it sends an ARP reply with its own MAC address to host A. Host A inserts the address of S1 into its ARP table. An employee who has access to host B has arrived and boots the computer. During this process, a gratuitous ARP is sent to all hosts. In a gratuitous ARP, the own IP address is set as target. The target MAC address is set to 0. The connected computers now know the MAC address of B and insert it into their ARP tables. If host B now establishes a connection to S1, for example, a TCP connection for data exchange, an ARP request is posed. The sender is host B. The target is S1. S1 sends its MAC address as ARP reply to host B. Host B now knows the address of S1 and inserts it into the table. Computer C is attached to the network and sends a gratuitous ARP containing A's IP addresses because it has been configured in a wrong manner. A sends an ARP reply with its MAC address. Once this reply is received by C, C learns that there is obviously another computer which already uses this IP address. It shows an error message on its screen with the text duplicate IP address. Afterwards, the IP address of C has to be changed. It now gets the IP address 192.122.10.4 and sends a new gratuitous ARP. Now all computers in the network know the MAC address of C and insert it into their ARP tables. Now there is an incident so that server S1 fails. The backup server S2 takes over the functionality of S1 and at first sends a gratuitous ARP request. As a consequence, all computers in the network know the MAC address of S2 and override the old entry of S1. As you can see, communication may not be interrupted even though server S1 is broken.